My name's Adam Sachs. I'm a neurosurgeon at the Ottawa Hospital. I subspecialize in spine surgery and functional neurosurgery. Deep brain stimulation surgery is a treatment for patients with movement disorders such as Parkinson's disease, in which we target a very specific and small area of the brain and manipulate the circuitry with stimulation, and this alleviates some of the symptoms. One of the key functions that any surgeon does in any surgery is try to estimate and understand the anatomy as the operation proceeds. Most operations are visual experiences. As we open up, we see anatomical landmarks and are able to reconstruct the anatomy visually. In deep brain stimulation surgery, because the target is in the middle of the brain, we enter with microelectrodes and have to listen to the signature sounds of each different brain area, of the nuclei and the areas in between the nuclei. This leaves the surgeon with the problem of how to visualize that and understand the area and where we need to go. So what we're intending to do is use a virtual reality environment constructed from the patient's own MRI and a deformable atlas and input the physiological information that we have in real time and manipulate it in a virtual reality environment to better appreciate and understand the three-dimensional anatomy and be able to make decisions online in surgery that are more refined and more precise. We plan to start using this in the operating room at the Ottawa Hospital. By having a more precise target that's defined by physiological boundaries and updated on the patient's own MRI, we'll have more precise and accurate information to make clinical decisions about where to place the electrode and hopefully be able to get better impact of the stimulation with less unwanted side effects. Well, there's nowhere else in the world that we know of that is using virtual reality in this fashion and integrating all aspects of the physiology and anatomy to create a precise anatomical map to place deep brain stimulation electrodes. This is really exciting. This is a project that I've been thinking about over the past 5 years. When I do deep brain stimulation surgery and I'm trying to recreate the patient's anatomy in my mind, it always seemed to make sense to actually be able to have a three-dimensional representation in the virtual reality environment. And it was great when we were able to team up with Justin Sutherland and the Realize Lab and actually start to make advances in this project and actually bring it to the operating room.